We're about to begin a study of frontier molecular orbital theory. The FMO topic has as much to do with constructing and using models as anything else. Models are important in chemistry, just as they are in many other fields of science, and good models allow you to solve a wider range of problems than you'd ever be able to address by memorization alone. I was first introduced to this way of thinking in about 1983 by Professor Peter Beak, who's now my colleague, but at that time he was my professor. He's currently teaching Chem 236, and because Professor Beak's course had such an impact on me, I thought it would be interesting to join him in his office and ask him a few questions. So welcome, Peter. Thanks for being here and joining our Chem 332 webcast.
Thank you, Jeff.
So a lot of students think that organic chemistry is just a subject to approach by memorization and regurgitation, and I'm curious what advice you might give them.
I think the best way to learn organic chemistry is by recognizing that they're reproducible patterns. Many of these patterns fall under the category of reasoning by analogy, so that if you know one kind of structure or one kind of reaction, you know many similar structures and many similar reactions.
That's interesting. The first time I heard the words reason by analogy, they were uttered from your mouth. So that was when I was a student in 339. Can you explain how that applies to organic chemistry?
Well, in organic chemistry, there are, of course, millions of reactions. But in fact, there are really only, this discussion about this, maybe 5 to 7 different types of reactions. So if you can recognize the type of reaction in an original form, it can be applied in many, many cases. And you don't have to memorize. In fact, no one could memorize all the possibilities.
So is reason by analogy a phrase that you initiated, or did somebody teach you this approach?
I doubt that I initiated it. It probably came from professors who I learned from. I would mention probably George Hammond and Ernest Wenker, who were physical organic and synthetic organic chemists. And they certainly taught by pointing out the similarity between different kinds of reactions and different kinds of synthesis.
So is reason by analogy an approach that applies to other areas of science, or is it only applicable to organic chemistry?
I think reason by analogy is the way scientists think about everything. We have to understand our observations in terms of what we know, and we seek analogies. There's actually a very interesting book by a former professor in chemistry here, Ted Brown, called Metaphors in Science, which deals with this topic in philosophy as well as in science.
And since we're getting into the FMO theory, I was wondering if you have any insights on the origin and evolution of the subject. It's a topic that really started appearing in the literature about 60 years ago, and you might have some interesting insights on the topic.
At that point, it was considered pretty much the realm of the physical chemist, and the organic chemist really didn't use it very often, although a few pioneers did. E.J. Corey, who was in this department at the time, coined the term stereoelectronic control, in which the orientation of pi orbitals making a pi bond were critical in understanding the stereochemistry of a reaction. There was some photochemistry done in Europe by Hovinga, and a physical chemist there named Osterhoff commented on the importance of both occupied and unoccupied molecular orbitals in a reaction. Organic chemists at the time, though, thought that unoccupied orbitals had very little to do that would be of interest in understanding reactions.
All right. Thanks a lot, Peter. I appreciate taking the time to talk to our students.
Thank you, Jeff.